guess to start off, can you like share with our savers, you know, what we can expect from this new album? It's next week, right?
Yeah, it's a week from, it's called Wake Up the Sleepers, and it comes out a week from last Tuesday, so I guess 5 days from now or something. And what you can expect, I guess, if you know, if you're already a Kalyana fan, if you know the history of the band, if you know the catalog of the band, this is basically a summary of everything we've done. This is our chance to kind of unite the older area fans with our newer fans, you know? So it's I mean, it's my favorite, like, by far the best record we've ever done. It goes just much deeper, much darker than we've ever done. And lyrically, it's just got, I think, more sincerity than I've had in a long time. So we self-produced it, which gave us the freedom to basically do whatever we wanted. Which is how it was in the old, you know, before the whole major label thing. Hang on a second.
Do you feel like your sound's mature? It's your ego,
you're like, we don't know what we am. You see, it's only what
they're for, right?
Oh, man.
What was the question?
How do you feel like your sound's mature over the years?
You know, as a songwriter, you spend a lot of time, I think, in the first few years, you know, echoing stuff that your idols have done, and then you kind of find your own sound, and then you learn. In our case, since we write essentially pop music, you spend a lot, I mean, regardless of how it sounds, just generally speaking, it's American pop music, as opposed to like classical or folk or whatever. You spend time learning conventions of like song structure, arrangement, instrumentation, things like that, and then you spend, which is where we are now, I think, in the last few years, really learning how to totally break all the conventions, how to defy those sort of formulas, while at the same time making tunes that are super cool to listen to. You know, we're not doing anything necessarily avant-garde, but I think I'm proud of the way that we're thinking outside the box and stuff like that. So there's songs on this record that are, you know, 6 or 7 minutes long. We haven't been able to do that in years, and there are a lot of songs that whose structures are pretty atypical. At the same time, they're incredibly catchy, and they're epic, and they're moving, and I don't know, some of them are just going to be hard to describe. Like, I think the journalists are going to get migraines from this record.
I didn't get a migraine. I have listened through it.
No, I think a migraine when you sit down to actually write about it.
Yeah.
Because your head's going to be spinning, you know? Like, what adjectives do you use?
We run into that problem all the time. Yeah. So there's a lot of guest appearances on this album too. So you've got Benji Matt, Amanda Palmer, Chibi from Birthday Massacre. What was it like working with them? You know, like, what did they kind of bring to the table?
Well, and a lot of times what they brought to the table was like the ability to hit notes that I can't hit. Benji Matt, that was just an education for us. He's been a good friend, but I've never worked with him in the studio before. And he just came in and killed it. Like, just showed me a lot about just vocalizing, I guess. It's ridiculous. The harmonies, I learned a lot about harmony. So, a lot more harmonies on the trumpet than I had. A lot more, in terms of vocals, it's a lot more layered and texture, and really had a lot of fun with just the sonics on this record, and Chibi came in, and I think having a female local just always adds a certain dimension of drama and just kind of it's a kind of cinematic quality. Like, I always, a lot of songs are about relationships or about scenes almost from movies, and so when you hear a girl's voice in there, to me it just makes it much more of an experience. And so she comes in, and when she comes in, like, she comes in hard, like on the chorus of the song Mouth to Mouth, and it's like, it's super bold, and everybody can hear that song immediately. Who the fuck is that?
I love her. I'm begging for their band to just get some more notoriety, because they're really big here in Philly whenever they come through, and just, she's amazing.
Yeah.